Ladies and gentlemen, you are tuned to Chances of Wolves Radio. We are on East Village Radio. This is episode 132. We have very special guests in the studio. Mr. Melvin Van Peebles, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, yo. What up?
How you doing?
Excellent.
Paula? Moist Paula in the house?
Hello.
Paula's my baritone.
Hmm? Barry
baritone sax, yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Her new band, yeah. Got it together, young girl. Mm-hmm.
So, you have a new band?
Yeah, my band is called Lassiter, because I don't take no... Well, I don't know if I can say it on the air.
You can say whatever you want, man. Huh?
I don't take no stuff. Well, anyway, it starts with an S. You know what I'm saying.
Gotcha. Yeah. How long has this new band been together?
Well, we played the first real gig...
This Thursday night.
Thursday night, yeah.
Joe's Pub.
Joe's Pub, yep.
7 p.m.
But I did Sweetback as an opera at the beginning of last year with Burnt Sugar, the chamber orchestra of Burnt Sugar. And seven of the members that I have in Laxative are from Burnt Sugar. We went to France and did the show and so forth. And the guys, they had it together. So that's, I took those members. They all had it together, but I didn't need 12 people. So, and Paula was one of them. And there's Jared, and there's Bruce, and there, you know, the whole gang. They're deaf. They had the shit together.
Yeah, they played. Were you there when they played Southpaw?
Burnt Sugar. Yeah. I played that with Burnt Sugar.
Yeah, so yeah. that was.
We did it like two or three times on Wednesday.
Yeah, and that was, I thought, one of the best shows.
Oh, you did?
I saw last
year.
Great. Yeah,
thank you so much.
I was impressed. I didn't get out to see the musical, but
yeah. Well, Burnt Sugar always
came
is
to me.
Up to something different.
Yeah.
You know, we did Sweetback with Melvin last year, which was a great opportunity. And we've been working on the music of James Brown for most of the past year. We're doing that at the Apollo on January 13th.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
And that's third time doing that there, so that's another thing that Burnt Sugar does. But we're all Sweetback fans.
Yeah,
you know, it's quite interesting. It's going to be very interesting down at Joe's Pub. I don't know if they've ever seen the group of followers, those folks that hang around my type of work, but it should be very interesting.
Uh-huh. We get to play some of the music from Sweetback a little bit, and then...
From Sweetback, from some of my Broadway shows, from some of the movies, and some new stuff.
It's an honor to have you here. We play your records all the time on our show.
So as you know, Melvin has made 8 or 9... great records.
Yeah, I have all of them.
Yeah, he's a prolific singer-songwriter, so the show will really showcase that because he's so well-known as a filmmaker, but a lot of people don't realize that he has this incredible catalog of records.
Well, I thought I might as well have the fun and step on out myself, you know what I mean? So just might as well come on out myself and sing the songs. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And we've had some surprise appearances from Melvin around town lately, and he is a visceral lead singer.
Yeah. I was gonna say, so is this the first, formally, like, you performing yourself live?
No. I mean,
you've been doing that for a long time.
Oh, no. I mean, I've done it all over. I used to drive cable cars in San Francisco, and sometimes I do that. And I haven't played much in L.A. I played a lot in Europe in public. But I haven't really had a big major show like this since the Bastille in about 2003 or something like that. Maybe it was 2001 I did a show with my French contingent.
So you lived out there for a while, right?
I still do.
I still live.
And I live here. It was a tough life, but somebody's got to do it. You know what I mean?
I read something I couldn't believe, that you worked translating Mad Magazine into French. Is that true?
Mm-hmm. I worked for a magazine called Arikiri in France, and they would take episodes from Mad and I do it into French.
How do you say "what me worry" in French?
They don't say "what me worry,"
right.
But moi j'en fais rien, je m'en fous.
Must have been a misprint when I read it. I was like, really? That's a job that somebody has?
Really, what's happened is because it was very tough, because a lot of the things were so idiomatic about what has happened here. Didn't translate. I just translated in the opposite direction. I was at the Guggenheim. Uh-huh. I was doing Jean Cocteau into English, and if you just translated it straight, it made no sense, each one of these things has a different meaning in the language.
All the cultural references and all that.
Yeah, when you're doing something idiomatically, I mean, like when you say "shut up," it doesn't mean the same thing as "shut up."
Yeah, exactly. Right.
So that's really fun. And then the Cocteau thing at the Guggenheim there is because also you got a 30-year difference in the if somebody in English said you was 23 Skidoo, you wouldn't know what you were talking about.
Uh-huh,
with that.
Uh-huh.
The whole largo, which is slang in French, is changed.
Uh-huh. Fascinating.